hate love between need of belonging and need of self-assertion. That's just differently expressed the same kind of conviction. Belonging. Community stands for belonging. I belong to community. Community is there to come to my help in case of necessity. That's the at least ideal type of community. But community also, first of all, community is aware that I am its member, that I belong to community, and if I betray the trust, the admission ticket they gave me, they can kick me out. They watch, they are interested. They may declare me heretic, traitor, treacherous element, unreliable element, for one reason or another, they can blackball me. So I am under constraint. I pay for relative security, that I can count on collectivity, but at the same time, I am constrained in my freedom. I have to follow the rules. I can't fall out from them. That's very unpleasant. Pleasantness and unpleasantness are connected in community life. I didn't suggest, contrary to what you said, that community stands for paradise. Paradise, I suggested, stands for lack of choice. Not lack of necessity, like lack even of the idea of choosing between one kind of being together and another kind of being together. Everything is given. Now that is not the case of community, because community lives alongside other ways of life. Not like in paradise, where everything was the same for everybody, which means Adam and Eve. It's very easy to make everything the same for two people. It's much more difficult in case of community. But community, I belong to community if I am a member of community. We replace community to some extent with something very different, which is called network. Network which has been made possible by invention and wide world distribution of internet. A network is different sort of fish, very different from community. To start with, I belong to community, but network belongs to me. I am creating my network by making a list of my friends on Facebook. People who write to me, I write to them. We are talking about the same things. We are exchanging tweets and things like that. And I transformed the replacement of community from the sphere of belonging to the sphere of self-assertion. I treat counterfactually, to be sure. I treat my network as the aspect of my self-assertion. Because by answering or refusing to answer messages, I take control over the group to which I decided to belong on condition that they satisfy my expectations. I am in control. That is the practice for most of the people today. Network is not going a long way towards community. And one of the reasons why fundamental movements today find such a wide circus of supporters. People are not satisfied with this replacement of community. They forgot that community had all sorts of restraints around, which tampered, which restricted their ability to self-assertion. That is forgotten, this unpleasant aspect. And because network has strict the old-fashioned community out of this artisan aspect. But having stripped from this artisan aspect, having surrendered the task of balancing freedom and security, at the same time, network developed dream of belonging. Dream of belonging. You are dreaming of belonging. People who are joining fundamentalist movement, religious fundamentalist movement, other ethnic fundamentalist movement, newly chauvinistic nationalism emerging in so many countries, building borders, building camps for the immigrants and things like that, all that is expression of the tacit or explicit. Very often we don't know what is eating us, but nevertheless inside us there is this unsatisfied need of being, of belonging to a group with steady borders, not recreated every moment like networks are by connecting or disconnecting, but being given as a firm ground on which to put your feet. I am not singing praise of community here. I am simply trying to diagnose the present-day sentiments which justify to pendulum swinging once again in my life, not from security to freedom, but now from freedom to security. And that's a very dangerous moment, which needs to be watched, because remember that the more you get of one value, which is central to human dignity and human agreeable life, the more you lose of the other value, which is equally crucial and equally indispensable.
Listen, Gudmund, do you prefer signing the book here or in the outside? I close now, I say two words and I close in the outside.
There is a table there.
There is a table, okay. Bene, allora penso che sia il caso di concludere, perché è passata più di un'ora e comunque, anche se è un giovanotto, insomma, non deve stancarsi troppo. Un'ultima considerazione personale volevo fare a proposito della vita del network. C'è una metafora molto bella che della distopia che, insomma, sia Zygmunt Bauman sia io preferiamo, che è la possibilità di un'isola di Welbeck, dove questi cloni, questo Daniel 24 e poi Daniel 25, poi le donne clonate, le poche persone che sono sopravvissute, possono comunicare soltanto davanti agli schermi. E fuori pulsa la vita, ma la vita che pulsa là fuori è una vita che assomiglia abbastanza a quella degli tagliagole dell'ISIS, perché sono persone assolutamente crudeli, selvagge, sono però è una vita che pulsa, è una vita, sono i barbari che sono rimasti, che non sono stati clonati, e poi ci sono questi qua che sono sottili, stanno dietro i loro schermi, nelle loro case, non escono mai, non hanno neanche bisogno di mangiare, dovrebbero essere felici, però a un certo punto il protagonista, l'ultimo dei cloni, decide che quella non è vita, perché non si può rimanere così in superficie, non si può rimanere davanti a uno schermo. Piuttosto prende il suo cane e va in mezzo ai barbari, che sono armati di asce, che sono feroci, ma lui va, perché la vita è insieme agli altri, non può essere soltanto dietro uno schermo. Ecco. Grazie a tutti. Per chi lo desiderasse, il professor Bauman firmerà le copie dei suoi libri qua fuori, perché c'è un banchetto. Arrivederci.